they're not rented, they're vacant, and the management company is not making a profit. Will they lower their standards for the qualifying process?
No. They will not. If, first of all, the management company won't get paid, and since you have a developer owning the management company, he's also subject to feeding this project. If it doesn't cash flow, then they're not going to lower the standards. Because first of all, standards as far as who is eligible don't change. As far as people that have been convicted of crimes or have been convicted of drugs, people who have bad credit will not be tenants because the credit reports will be run as well as all of the background checks will be run. And that's a requirement. Not the management, but that's a requirement of the government.
Is it more likely that the management company will change hands because of no profit units are vacant? 64 units is a lot of units. We have so much vacancy now with USDA, you know, there's units, condo apartments that are available and they're open. So I'm just wondering.
Well, the only way the management company would change is if the investor felt that the management company was doing a poor job. The management representing this group for as many years as I have, they have never, ever not managed anything that they have developed.
Is that all residents have to do, the background checks, or just one that's on the lease?
No, it's everybody. In other words, every resident. You have to give them a name that's going to live there, and they all get checked.
Yes, but how about you can't guarantee that for the wealth of the people that come in and stay with them? I understand that that's good credit and no crime or anything, but that doesn't say that someone, a relative from out of town or someone, doesn't come stay with them and do something, and there's no way to prevent that. No visit.
Well, there's no way to check if somebody's going to come visit, and that
I
person.
I know, but what I'm saying is, you don't, not even though the person is good, you can't be responsible for what their family members do or have done in the past that's possibly affected.
Again, I guess the answer to the question is that if somebody comes to visit, not to live, if they come to live, then they too have to qualify as a resident. Because it's the residents. If they come to visit, then you're right. There's, you know, there's no way to check up on who's there other than what the other tenants tell you what's going on. And I'll assure you that if there's a bad apple, they'll find out.
How long ago is it for find out that they got this
because
they stay there 3 or 4 months?
Well, that's the job of a management company because there's a resident manager on the ladder. Huh?
Don't worry about it.
All of that y'all can call out the way out.